I'm in a junkyard. Unfortunately, it is a little bit windy today, so bear with me. Now, this one, to me, when I saw it the first time here, I thought, oh look, this looks just like a Chevrolet Caprice. But then there's slightly differences, it's more rounded. It's really basically the same overall shape, but also perhaps not as wide as the Caprice as I remember it. But perhaps the video is meant for maybe two reasons. One, you can see it right away. Hopefully the camera will capture the shade of this. Now I could see blue here and magenta there, but if I would change the angle, now I see magenta here and blue on the other side, so it does reflect with the sunlight. Definitely custom color. But look at this car, just look quickly without paying much attention. It has a very it's the first time I've seen this, at least in Canada. I imagine the US people are much more imaginative and yeah, more cultural than us in Canada. We are a little bit asleep here, but it has an anti-vol system to it, and you can see it from here, from this angle. Just give it a few seconds maybe, and just look a little bit at the details of the car. So for those people who got the idea, door handle shaving. I mean, how cool is this? Is it like a anti-vol, or is it just for the looks, or both? Now you may ask, how did I get into the car? How did the people get into the car? Because they need to empty a little bit, check inside when they put it in the scrapyard. There was an open window, so I slid my hand and got it open. I would say perhaps they got a remote that would unlock the doors, and also somehow maybe the door will just pop open. They possibly maybe have installed something, a mechanism, custom obviously. It's not nothing to really write home about inside. I try to remember that Chevrolet Caprice, which was the very first car, and I think I did a video on one like that. This is Canada, so kilometers that we see here, but look at the digits, they are so jumpy. So this is so tempered. But yeah, I was saying about the Caprice, and I feel indeed that this car is smaller than the Caprice. Caprice was a taxi car that went to drive through Toronto, and someone relative, that person gave the car to my dad, and my dad gave the car to me, and I blew its engine obviously, and I gave it to the junkyard. Actually, I did drove it to the junkyard with a blue rod. It was a story I put somewhere on the channel. It went I went to fire up the car, the engine, at minus 40 Celsius and Fahrenheit. That's where the two measures are the same. And unfortunately, what happened is it did fire up, but I give it some gas. I'm talking about the Caprice. I give it some gas and the pedal got stuck at minus 40. And through my student mind at that point, I had this, what should I do? The engine was screaming. Should I turn off the key? And I thought if I would turn off the key, I would kill the engine. So I didn't turn off the key. At the end, I think I pulled on the pedal after maybe 30 seconds or so, 1 minute perhaps. And yeah, at that moment, the engine was clacking, clacking. And I actually did drop the car to the junkyard just like that. And they gave us $400. I do still remember that car, a big car inside. One of the things I didn't like for that car is the seats were very low to the floor. But this one, and I'm guessing it's a celebrity Chevy, the seats are, hey, this is not, yes, they are low to the floor. You can perhaps figure out by the, actually you see the angle, it's my legs are making with my hips, so it goes downwards like this. That means the seat is low to the floor. I would not call this comfortable. But the seats are nice, and the legroom, it's missing a few inches, but it's not intolerable. There's not a lot of yeah, there's decent legroom on this, but the seats are comfortable. I like these seats. Yeah, even lumbar support. I have a bad back, lower back, and yeah, very nice seats. You actually, because I went to try cars, modern cars, and I don't find seats this comfortable in 2020 cars. I'm not talking about whatever higher end cars. In my channel, you would see perhaps I do price the some Lincoln cars and even some Ford cars for their seats, but many, let's say, cheap to average priced cars don't have nice seats, but 2020 standards. And I think there's someone, I do watch that channel for Motor Week, and I do recommend you see their reviews. You should check for Motor Week retro reviews. The guy is always John, I think. It's always complaining there's no battery gauge. This actually is not a gauge, it's just a light, and he's complaining there's no oil pressure gauge either. Yeah, very basic inside. Let's just have a look for the engine, perhaps. I will try my lower back to lift this 100 pounds hood. Okay, so it does have fuel injection. Perhaps it was pretty new back then, 2.8 V6, I think. I cannot really, there's three plugs in the front, so I would guess there's three others in the rear. It's like, it's a weird, no, it's okay, it's okay, it's nothing. The engine mounting is not that particular. So yeah, throttle body, cable throttle body, yes, these were the best. The electronic pedals usually are pretty nicely done, depends on the car, but you just don't get that feeling with the throttle body cable. With a cable throttle body, when you press the pedal, you just instantly feel the engine reaction. And now the electronic pedals, gas pedals, I know some people with BMWs did complain, maybe not the later models. I drive a Sonata, and actually even the Volvo S60 had the electronic pedal. Both were fine, but I do remember the feeling I had on a Honda Civic from 90s, just snapping like this, and the engine will react right away at the instant. Big trunk and this crazy magenta color. These guys went really over the head, and you see here it looks blue in the sunshine, and here it looks magenta. Yeah, custom color. I hope these guys did enjoy their car. Maybe they will see it once onto YouTube just for one last time. All right, thanks for watching.